A wave source emits a wave that propagates through space to freely transmit energy. We call this kind of wave a traveling wave or a progressive wave. What would happen to the wave if I put a boundary at this end? The wave will reflect when it meets the boundary, and upon reflection, the wave becomes 180 degrees out of phase with the original wave. Imagine the original wave flipping upside down so that these two waves are now in anti-phase. What we now have are two waves that have the same amplitude and wavelength. They are traveling in the opposite direction and they interfere. When the two waves overlap, they produce an interference pattern that does not travel through space. But the resultant wave pattern simply looks like a wave oscillating in one place. We call this type of waves a standing wave or a stationary wave. Since standing waves cannot propagate through space, there is no net transfer of energy. Think about how interference works. If we have a maximum particle displacement here and minimum displacement here, they cancel out to give zero disturbance in the resultant wave. We call this point a node for no displacements. When maximum displacement interferes with a point with zero displacements, it produces an anti-node in the resultant wave. There is intense disturbance here. Let's look more closely at what the particles are doing between two nodes. Between two adjacent nodes, all these particles are at maximum disturbance. That's because at the next instance in time, they will all move downwards. But between these two nodes, the particles all move upwards in the next moment. This means that all these particles here are in phase with each other, but they are in anti-phase with these particles. Generally speaking, particles between two adjacent nodes in a standing wave are in phase with each other. Here's a summary of the differences between a traveling wave and a standing wave. Traveling waves can transfer energy, but a standing wave can't do that. The amplitude of every particle is the same in a traveling wave because each particle can take turn oscillating to the maximum displacement. But in a standing wave, every particle's amplitude is different. In a traveling wave, the particles are only back in phase after one whole wavelength. But all particles between two nodes are in phase in a standing wave.